Welcome to this session on Ages and Stages of Middle Childhood. In this presentation, you'll learn who is the middle childhood child, impacts on middle childhood, Maslow's theory of children's basic needs, seven domains of development. What is middle childhood? Middle childhood includes children between the ages of 6 to 12 years old. It's the period that follows the rapid development of early childhood and precedes the physical and emotional changes that accompany puberty. It's a time to explore the world and themselves. Who is the middle childhood child? This time period, children are able to refine and master the skills they developed in early childhood and then explore new skills. They want to build friendships. They want to figure out who they are and what they want to become. This is a time of inquiry, spontaneous self-directed play, discovery, self-expression, and creating meaning through new experiences. Imaginations and creativity flourish when in an environment that promotes this. Impacts on middle childhood. Think about the average child's day. They have a demanding lifestyle. Parents, teachers, and childcare staff all have different expectations. Some children have few support systems and greater responsibilities. Others have overpowering support systems that don't allow them to explore. Although children in this time period are developing similarly, each child is different because of their experiences, and therefore their needs are different. Maslow's theory is that a child's most basic needs must be met in order for him or her to achieve the higher needs and progress up the hierarchy. This diagram demonstrates Maslow's theory. Physical needs. The most basic requirements that supports a school-age child's life. Food, shelter, protection from harm, warmth, adequate clothing, preventative health and dental care, treatment of mental and physical conditions, hygiene, safety, rest, activity, vaccination. Psychological needs. The conditions and support a child needs to enable him or her to grow, learn, adapt to the world, and ultimately be successful. Most of these are based on solid and reliable relationships, being nurtured, attachments to adults, effective parenting, security, trust, caring, belonging, opportunity to discover, play and learn, reciprocal relationships. Self-actualization, a state of being in which the school-age children can become their best, achieve their potential, and feel confident in themselves and their place in the world. Needs at this stage include spiritual exploration, beauty, creativity, truth and meaning, beauty, goodness, unity, uniqueness, playfulness, simplicity, and meaning. We now know that children develop in predictable stages that are progressive. We also know that children are individuals and that they develop at their own rates, and this is influenced by many things: genes, basic needs being met, supportive adults present in their lives, positive peer relationships, opportunities to explore, learn, and discover, pressures or stressors on kids' lives, etc. Taking all of this into consideration, we're now going to look at each domain of development. There are seven domains of development that we're going to address, and this is considered the whole child. These domains are physical development, social development, self-development, moral development, cognitive development, language development, creative development. Let's dive into physical development. Children are continuing to grow. Physical development and growth is dependent upon adequate nutrition, active bodies, and emotional well-being. Physical growth is individual. Some children grow and mature more quickly than others. Children are refining their gross and fine motor skills. Growth is still happening, and the children are refining the skills they've learned this far. They need time to practice, make mistakes in a safe environment, try new things, challenge themselves. Here's an example of physical development for a child who's 5 to 8 years old versus a child that's 9 to 12 years old. Now let's look at social development. Children are learning how to make and keep friends. The success of the process impacts the child's chances of having and keeping positive relationships in adulthood. Children are learning socially acceptable behaviors. Children begin to prefer playing with their same gender. Boys enjoy playing with large groups of boys, and girls play with smaller groups of girls. Some children will need help and encouragement to join a group and make friends. Others seem to do it quite easily. children who experience positive relationships also show more resilience. Here's an example of social development for a child who's 5 to 8 years old versus a child that's 9 to 12 years old. Moving on to self-development. Children struggle between independence and dependence. Most children have an accurate concept of themselves, and this can be encouraged through acknowledging achievement. Children are learning to manage their own emotions and to control their actions. This is known as self-regulation. Children will often become conflicted because they want to do things on their own, but in other situations, they know they need an adult to support them. Think about the praise you give and make sure it's genuine versus empty, like, oh, good job, as you look the other way. Self-development includes self-regulation. Think about your program. What do you do to promote self-regulation? Provide choices, encouragement, talk about effects of behavior on others, i.e., if you put your shoes on, then we can all go play soccer outside. Your friends are waiting for you. They know you're an all-star goalie. Here's an example of self-development for a child who's 5 to 8 years old versus a child that's 9 to 12 years old. Moral development is next. Children are able to see another person's point of view and understand that it's okay if people think differently. Children want fairness and justice. Boys tend to want things fair and just, while girls tend to want people to feel cared for. Positive adult role models are essential for children to develop morally. This often leads to confusion when a child's home morals are different from school, childcare, or others. As a leader, it's important to set strong moral examples. It's also important to involve families in the program so that participants feel a connection between their home life and after-school life. Here's an example of moral development for a child who's 5 to 8 years old versus a child that's 9 to 12 years old. What about cognitive development? Cognitive development involves thinking, knowing, and learning. Convergent thinking, only one right answer, and divergent thinking, many possible answers. Children must use their cognitive skills, use it or lose it. Experiences are instrumental in the development of cognition, play and discovery. The brain is capable of many things, but it's extremely important that the brain makes new and frequent connections. What children learn through play and discovery often affects understanding. Cognitive development does not have to mean providing lessons or doing homework. It's simply providing opportunity for play and interaction. Here's an example of cognitive development for a child who's 5 to 8 years old versus a child that's 9 to 12 years old. Let's look at language development. It involves verbal and written communication. Children are expanding their vocabulary through interactions, relationships, books, songs, media and technology, joke or storytelling. Literacy experiences promote language development and cognition. Children need positive role models to demonstrate the importance of using their words to communicate. Encourage children to use verbal or written communication as much as possible by asking questions or creating a pen pal program with another after-school site location. Here's an example of language development for a child who's 5 to 8 years old versus a child that's 9 to 12 years old. Lastly, creative development is the ability to have different ideas and to think of multiple ways of doing things. Artists, authors, dancers, composers, fashion designers, architects, etc. Creativity is not taught. Children need to feel safe and to be provided with materials, space, time, and sometimes basic instruction, i.e. how to stitch fabric. Children need to be provided with a variety of experiences to explore their creativity every day. Here's an example of creative development for a child who's 5 to 8 years old versus a child that's 9 to 12 years old. Things to keep in mind as a leader working with middle childhood participants is that they are sequential. The stages go step by step. They tend to relate to observable changes, are usually described with reference to the behaviors we can see the child demonstrate. They're qualitatively different. The stages are different in their details, not just their dimensions. They change from simple to more complex. The stages tend to increase in their complexity. They may be linked to ages, but the link is just an approximation. Development is highly individual, although it follows the same sequence of advancement. They may or may not progress in each domain at the same rate. Some domains may progress more quickly than others. There's a wide range of phases within each stage. Understanding development is critical. The behaviors that are developmentally appropriate for this age group may not necessarily be ones that we like. Your job is to understand each child and their development and use the information from this presentation to channel behaviors positively. For more information on programming for this age group, visit www.onafterschool.ca. Thank you for checking this session out.